You're watching
The
Dave Show. Hey guys, it's Danielle.
Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to do a waterfall braid. I got quite a few emails about that one, so shout out to Kara. I'm doing this one for you. Anyways, before I do that, I'm just going to show you guys a couple of products that I use on my hair to keep it nice whenever it's straight. So the first product that I use, for, you know, just in general for different hairdos, sometimes you need to keep your edges down, and that's when I would use Jam Gel. I use the Extra Hold just because I don't want to fool with it and I don't want to have to put a lot on. Because a lot of times, since my hair is naturally curly, if I put too much, you know, of something on it, it'll just curl up right away. So, the Extra Hold Jam Gel, I'm going to hold it up so you guys can see it. Okay. And then, I use Moroccan Oil. It's really nice. I found that My hair needs moisture and oil, but I don't want to make my hair look oily or feel oily, so this is perfect. Just, you know, one squeeze, and I'm going to hold it up to the camera so you guys can see it. Moroccan oil. And I use the light. There's actually two kinds. The other one I've used as well. It's the normal just Moroccan oil. It doesn't say light on it, though. But this one I found is just a little bit more heavier, and I think it's really about your preference which one you're going to have to use, so try them both out, see which one you like. But I, like I said, I use the one that's light. You can see where it says light on it. Perfect. So anyways, just rub it in my hands and, you know, put it towards, you know, the ends, my tips. Get it on all my hair, and it really, I actually also use this Moroccan oil when my hair is curly sometimes, you know, if I'm gonna put it in a bun, just to, you know, make sure the moisture stays. Even though my hair is straight, it's still curly, so it needs moisture without making it curl up. So I've definitely found that the Moroccan oil is great for that. You don't have to use too much. It smells good. I wish you could smell it, but it's not like you can smell it on camera, so yeah. That's what I use on my hair. It keeps it looking nice. Ta-da! There are also a couple other products that I use when I'm straightening my hair, and I thought I'd get this out of the way because I don't straighten my hair often. But when I do, I make sure that I take care of it and I keep my hair healthy without breaking it. That's how you get long hair. So, which one am I going to show you first? I will show you, it's a 10. It's a Miracle Shine Spray with Nani oil. You guys can see that right there. It's a 10. Okay. I use this a lot while straightening. First, I'll put the Moroccan oil in, and then I will spray this on whatever section I'm spraying or straightening, and it keeps my hair nice. And then, a lot of people might even think this is weird, but the next product that I use, and I put this in when I'm done straightening overall, it is the Just For Me. I know, everyone used this when they were a kid, but I still use it. Moisturizing lotion. Now the thing about this is, when your hair is straight, and I don't use a relaxer or anything, so I really don't know how, I don't know about that. But I do know that when you put this in, I can only put a little bit in, a little bit on the tip. I'm not going to do it now because I don't need to. I've already done it earlier in the week. But I just put it there, rub it in my hands like I did with the Moroccan oil, and get it. I like to get this one all over close to the root and bring it down. And then I put my comb blow dryer. For those of you who don't know what a comb blow dryer is, it's just a blow dryer that you can attach a comb to. Sometimes it comes with a brush and often different sizes for the combs. It helps with straightening hair. It makes the job a lot faster because it dries the hair at the same time as smoothing it out. And I just go through it, and I make sure I do the comb blow dryer right after that, because like I said earlier, a lot of products, when you put it on, will actually make it your hair kind of, you know, curl right back up. So this definitely has some moisture in it, almost a little too much. So I use the comb blow dryer right away through my hair right afterwards. And then I usually put my hair up in a wrap. And then I only do this maybe once or twice throughout the week. You can judge on your own hair. Everyone's hair is different, but yeah. Now I'm going to show you guys how to do the French braid, the waterfall braid. Okay. So let's see if I can do this in here. I'm going to start off by taking a section, the section for me that I would do, and you can choose where exactly you want it on your head, guys. It's your hair. Do what you want. But I would take the part where my bangs would be. These used to be bangs, but I grew them out. Pretty long now. Anyways, so take them here. And what you're going to do is separate into three sections, just like if you were going to braid it. Okay? And then I'm going to have you start off with braiding it, just like a normal French braid. Okay? And then what you do is you leave this piece down. Like after you do the first braid and you go over on the other side, the one that's on the bottom, you leave down. And then with this top side up here, you're going to continue to add hair in. So add hair in just like you would a normal, you know, braid. Cross it over. And then when it's comes back time to cross this side over, you're going to grab hair right from behind where you dropped it. So I dropped this hair here. I'm going to grab some right here, right next to it. And instead, what you're going to do is actually pull that hair over instead. Do you see what I'm saying? Do you see how it's going? And then you drop this one. Now I'm going to fast forward a little bit because from here on out it is the same repetitive motions, adding strands of hair to the top and then releasing the lower strand of hair and grabbing a new one from behind the last one and adding it in and continuing the braid like normal. When you're finished with all of it, you should end up with something like this. Now I'm going to show you on my friend Sydney's hair how to do it because her hair is a little bit lighter and it will show up a little bit better. Sydney, wave to the camera really quick. All right. She's a little camera shy. But here we go. So it's going to start off just like a French braid. So section your hair, get your starting section, okay? And I usually like to start it off a little bit bigger, just that way you can see it better. But anyways, so like a normal braid, get it into your three sections and make them nice and neat. And then begin like you would a normal French braid. Okay? So you started it. So everything's nice and clean. And just like you would up at the top, you would add some hair in and connect it to the piece that you're going to, you know, move next. And so just like you would add to the top, do that. Cross it over like normal. But then when you get here, what you're going to do is let go of this hair here. So you're going to let that go. And in doing that, you're going to pick the hair that is actually behind it, right behind it. And you're going to take that instead and cross it over the hair that you just crossed. Okay, so now you've got this one down. And this has been crossed. Next, continue like you would a normal French braid. Add on to the next part. Grab a little bit of hair from up here. I always throw it forward, that way I can brush the rest of it down so it still looks nice and neat. Then I grab the hair that I threw forward and I add it to my section. And what I'm going to do from here is cross it over like I normally would. Then, once again, this hair here, you drop. You just let go of. Now, once again, I'm going to fast forward because you're repeating the same motions of adding hair to the top like a normal French braid and releasing the bottom one. Now, the great thing about this braid
is that once you get the hang of it, it's really easy, and there are so many awesome creative things that you can do to it. At the end of this whole video, I will show you a small slideshow of some really cool ideas and different ways that you can get creative with it. I think you guys will really enjoy it, and now back to the video. Then, whenever you decide you want to be done, just go ahead. You can either put a ponytail here or you can braid it. It's up to you, really, how you want to do it. So, I'm just going to braid mine just because I'm not actually styling it right now. I'm just showing you how to do it. So, I'm going to braid it all the way till the end. Now, Sydney, show them your hair. All right, see it? There is your waterfall braid. Nice and pretty. And like I said, if any of these up here at the top start to bump, like for example, like this, start to bump, I gotta just pull it down from here. Nice and neat. So that is your waterfall braid. So this is your waterfall braid, and that's pretty much all to it. Like I said, it's a French braid. You know, you cross over, you bring the one over from the top, but then this one, instead of adding more hair, you leave that one and grab the one behind. It's really simple. If you remember that one rule, you will have a perfect waterfall braid. Here it is. Alrighty. And you can style it however you want. You can, you know, put it into an updo. You can do anything you want to it now. From here, it is your creative decision.